Boss up, get that money, secure that bag. Boss up, get that money, secure that bag. Boss up, boss up, get that money, get that money. She a queen and they love her cause she got her own place, own car, and she back home. Hey y'all, look, I had this major revelation just a couple of seconds ago sitting in my hot tail truck. Hold on, you know what? Let me close this door real quick and turn the AC on. Because something gotta be said. All right, hold on. All right, so as a child, my favorite animal has always been a rabbit. For whatever reason, I've always loved rabbits, and symbolically, rabbits represent. Okay, so symbolically, rabbits represent fertility. Y'all know I don't need that. abundance, wealth. Like, you know, some people be carrying around the daggone rabbit's foot, that type of stuff. But now, you know, I used to always ask my mom, like, well, I want a rabbit, I want a rabbit, I want a rabbit. Never got one. So, my oldest daughter just so happened to get one, right? So she's, you know, she's going through all her stuff, and you know, she come to find out she got two dogs. So she's like, Mom, look, these jokers like kids. I said, oh, you think? So she was like, I can't handle them two and the rabbit. So do you want them? I said, yes! All my little childhood memories came back. I'm like, oh, I'm finna get Peter the rabbit. So I'm all excited, right? A week go by. I'm like, girl, when am I gonna pick up my daggone rabbit? Shoot, where's my friend at? So I'm sitting there, right? And finally, her and her little friend was like, all right, Mom, here, come take this thing. I'm like, all right. So I go pick him up and, you know, put him in the car. You know, they put him in a little box or whatever in the car and bring him home. All the kids ripping and running with him and stuff like that. But there are some things that are starting to happen I didn't even realize. The first time I went over to my daughter's house, of course the rabbit was there. I started noticing that I started sneezing. I started noticing that my eyes was getting kind of itching. Eyes watering up so much I had to take my lashes off. I was mad, right? So I was getting a little bit upset. And I couldn't figure out, I was like doing that little scratchy of the throat thing. And I was like, what the world? I didn't realize it before. I'm sitting there and I'm like, girl, I gotta go, cause I mean, I don't know, something in your house. Maybe you need to go wipe the walls off or something. Maybe you got mold somewhere. It wasn't connecting. So I was like, girl, I gotta leave. Shoot, I can't be up in here. So I end up having to leave her house. But anyway, fast forward. The rabbit is not in the house, right? Y'all already know where I'm probably going with this. The rabbit is not in the house. That joker running up and down the steps. He, you know, he getting used to the kids. The kids all running, you know, ripping and running with him. And the oldest one, well, my second oldest, you know, he's growing an attachment to her. So he be up in her rooms, crawling all over her head and stuff. And I started noticing that I started having little problems with my breathing. No, it ain't no day on COVID, so stop it. Stop playing. So I'm sitting here looking like, so I'm doing all of that, and next thing you know, that joker went in my room. Now he underneath my bed, and I'm not putting two and two together. So I'm sitting there coughing and gagging. I'm like, what the de-? So I had, look, my room is on the third floor, right? So I'm sitting up there. I done put two ACs in my room. I'm like, well, you know what? Maybe it's the mold. So I'm sitting trying to get all the mold out the look. Maybe I said, you know, let me clean the filter off. I said, you know, let me turn my fan on. Why is this itching and why is this coughing coming back again? You know, I'm up there trying to check my face. I'm like, oh, you know, it ain't no like monkey pops or nothing. Let me check my lip, because everybody getting them little bumps on their bubbles on their lip. I'm like, it better not. So I'm sitting there looking all crazy. And I'm like, I'm Googling, what's the symptoms of, you know, COVID we've been having for 10 years now. I'm sitting there Googling, what the hell today going symptoms for COVID is again? Oh, I don't got none of that. So what the hell? Somebody at work just got it. I'm like, well, damn, did I get hell? So I'm sitting there, you know, trying to figure out. I know I bet not got it. So I'm sitting there trying to confuse as all get. I go in her room. I'm going up and down the steps. I'm coughing and gagging again. Next year, I said, you know, let me just go outside, because maybe, you know, we moving and all them boxes and all the dust done fell off, you know, from all the boxes. I'm like, let me go take a walk. I go take a walk. My breathing starts to come back. I mean, it's a little remnant there, you know, every now and then. A remnant, you know, the remnant of the cough was there. But I wasn't coughing like I used to. I wasn't gagging. I wasn't, you know, I didn't have the shallow breathing where, you know, your whole daggone little part right here, the whole thing done caved in, is on daggone it touching your spine. You know, I that started to go away. And I said, there, well, hold on, Shay. Every time I go back in that daggone house, I get to coughing and sneezing again. So that joker was underneath my bed. So I went into my room. I said, yo, Pepper. I called my daughter, Lyric. Come get this thing. I there's something I need to test out real quick. Come get this thing. Come here. Come get him. So he playing hide and seek. Oh. I said, look, he doing too much flipping around. He getting excited. He running up and he'll see her come. He'll poke his little head out. I said, Lily, here you go. She walk on this side, he run on the other side. I said, see, I ain't no rabbit can play games. So the thing, every time she go on that side, Pepper, come here. She calling his name. I said, can he hear you? I mean, do they really respond like a dog? Can they really respond? I was confused. So I'm sitting there like, what the devil? So finally, he lets her get him. So she look at him, she like, look, you better get over here if I won't, don't get you no water. And he look up at her like this, and he hop with his little tail right over there by her. I said, oh, he understand you. Ignorant, right? Mm-hmm. So she pick him up, and I was like, yeah, you better listen to her. Man, the minute I went to go grab his little foot, all of a sudden, I'm breathing heavy again. I said, I know good and doggone well I am not allergic to this daggone rabbit. It got so bad the other night. It was so bad, y'all. I had to go sleep out in my truck. You hear me? It was so bad. My chest was like literally in my daggone. You might as well say it done fell out my chest and fell in my booty somewhere, because I couldn't find it. Hell, I done coughed it up so much. I couldn't find it. Hell. So I'm sitting there like, I know good and doggone well I am not allergic to my favorite pet in the world. So a revelation, light bulb went off. Sometimes what we want so badly can be a detriment to our health, to our mental. It will allow us to have to uproot ourselves and go take care of business somewhere else. What we desire for so long, even from childhood, has allowed us that we look, even though it may look good, it's not for you. And sometimes I sat back and I said, man, if I would have got this little joker when I was younger, it possibly could have killed me. The way I'm coughing now, the way I'm breathing now, man, this little thing, the amount of love that I wanted from this pet, whatever, I don't know why I wanted a rabbit so much. I don't I don't know what it was, but I just wanted a rabbit so bad. I ain't want no dog. I ain't want no cat. I ain't want no nothing else. I wanted a rabbit. Why? I don't know. I don't know what the symbolism was. But anyway, what we want so daggone bad can be a detriment to, it's literally a life and death situation. What may be cute and cuddly and all look so innocent can have a fierce price tag along with it. Man, boy, that joker hit me so bad. I said, Shay, wake up. That's how the enemy can disguise his blessings. They can be so good and cuddly and, oh, she's so fine. Oh, he's so handsome and yada. But it could be deadly to your soul. It could be deadly to your mental health. It could be deadly to your overall well-being. What you desired as a child so much because you're innocent. You don't realize, you know, the cost of what you want. Now as an adult, I can clearly see. Boy, that revelation hit me so daggone hard. I didn't even realize what I was doing. And now this, my daughter is attached to this thing. I'm sitting out in the car now because I'm scared to go in there. So I do not want to go in my house. For real. Sad to say. But like, I'm sitting out here because I'm breathing regular. And all day at work today, I did not, you know, I didn't do that smoker's cough. I didn't do all that. Where it's telling you blowing a trumpet and so when you coughing and say, every now and then, clear as day, you can see the sign clear over there. Say, do not enter. That joker gonna go down the wrong way on purpose. That's that bull I'm talking about. And then say for instance he had a head-on collision, then he'd be the main one crying. What may look like the easy way out, oh, I'm just gonna go this way because all I gotta do is cut through this way and go up the street, can easily be your dog. You could have died just now, my guy. And there's another truck coming down the daggone way, and you gonna, all because you wanna take the easy way out, all because you wanna take the easy way? Folks are damn lazy, for real. That just made me like, took me off my daggone thinking. Well, that was another, God can be telling you, do not enter. Don't go that way. Leave that man alone. Leave that girl alone. Don't go for that job. I don't care how close it is to your house. I don't care how fine and sexy she is. I don't care, you know, how much money they offering. I don't care, you know, well, this person got connections, so they the plug. I don't care about none of that. Stay the course. Trust the process on everything that you do. But y'all, the most innocent thing that we want, could be our detriment. Boy, that thing hit me so daggone hard just now. I was like, man. And it was like, I was reading, and it was like bunnies carry a certain, like, this long word, stuff like, you know, on their saliva and in their fur, that once they're, you know, they get to jumping and hopping around every daggone where, it goes into the atmosphere. And that's what I'm breathing in, and whatever is on their tongue or in their fur, my body's not responding to. And for whatever reason, like, I'm gonna have to buy this joker a cage because I don't want to take the thing away from them. Like my kids, they never really had a pet like that. And I'm trying to tell them, like, wait till we move, like, wait till we, you know, get a house with a backyard and all that. You can keep them jokers outside, sure. Or keep them things in your room. So I'll take, look, if I get a house with a basement or something, I'll take the whole basement by myself. Y'all can shoot. But I'm have to buy that girl a cage or something. She can keep that joker outside. But don't have that thing hopping around underneath my bed. Shoot. Don't nothing belong under there. But for real, what we want so innocently, and what we think is best for us, because it look good, smell good, talk right, got making a certain type of money. I already talked to y'all about this. I already talked to you, and y'all must want me to keep repeating myself. I don't like doing that. But I just had to say that. Because it just, like I said, it hit me so hard. And I was like, you know what? Folk got to get out of that. Like, looks don't last. They don't let stuff start sinking, dimpling, hanging, getting a little stretch mark, getting a little dimples, whatever else it is. But it's up here, though. If me and you vibing right or whatever, you know, we on the same chemistry, whatever word else you want to use, I don't care. But that's what's going to keep the relationship. That's the foundation of any relationship or any friendship, acquaintance or whatever. That's the foundation. Is you can have two, like, you can look at a couple walking down the street like, oh, they look good. Oh man, she pretty as I don't know what, man, he fine. Or but for real, they don't like each other. Or you can see them couples that the man, the boy be fine as I don't know what. You be like, oh my gosh, girl. But then you look at the girl, and I mean, I'm not one to judge and be like, oh, she ugly. No, because there are some girls who be doing that. I'm not, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Stop playing. But then you look at the girl, and according to some other people's standards, she may not be the best, whatever. You know what I'm trying to say. And you be, what the world are he seeing her? Ew, she's ugly. She's da-da-da-da. Or she must give good. Or she must be, or she must got that. But sometimes it ain't about that. And vice versa. A gorgeous girl with a dude that look like he belong on daggone King Kong some daggone wear. And you looking like, what the? But they the best of friends, though. They are the best of their energy is like addicting. Like, when them two come around, or they the life of the party. Like, he treat her like a queen. She treat him like a king. And vice versa, whatever the case is. And they get along so well. Yes, they may have some minor arguments or whatever the case is. Debates or whatever word you want to say. But at the same time, though, you got Barbie and Ken over here arguing like cats and dogs. But then you got Shrek and Fiona. Or you got Prince. What's that thing off? What's that man name off of daggone Princess Tiana? Prince LaVie, whatever his name is. You got him and Fiona over here. The best of friends. Because that's what they understood. They understood the assignment of being friends first, setting that foundation. So they both understood each other on a deeper level. The inner me they see within each other. They're not only looking at the aesthetics. Oh, you know, she got a fat butt, small waist, thick thighs, brown eyes. Y'all know how I do. But it's not all about that. It's something else deeper than that. And that's what that daggone rabbit made me see. Like, Shay, I don't care what look good on the outside. I don't care what, you know, how innocent it may look like. Or I don't care how convenient it may be. That joker is deadly. That thing is deadly to you. And the longer you try to make excuses, the longer you try to, well, I'm just going to put him outside. Oh. Well, I'm just going to... No, God is telling you in this season, get rid of those who are causing a detriment to your life. If they not on the same page, not on the same page as you, get rid of it. Stop hanging out. Stop entertaining it. Let me cut my gas off, because I'm driving this daggone truck and gas already. Gas already creeping by my daggone house. I don't like that. People used to work would be creeping. Now I know where she live at. Anybody tell you go find it? Shoot. But you hear the wheeze? It's still there a little bit. I'm saying, I'm scared. That's why I'm still sitting out in this hot tail car. I'm scared to go in the house. Like, I know he's running around, all his fur flying in the air. And that's another thing. If you still keep them around, no matter how far they may be, but if you still reminiscing on the... If you still watching old show, videos that y'all done made, pictures that y'all done took, there's still a remnant there. You're still holding on. So there's still going to be that emotion there. God is telling you, you need to let go of that because it's going to end up killing you. We always talk about protecting your peace 101. That is not protecting your peace. Keeping something around that's gonna end up hurting you in the long run. God had already sent you the red flags. The red flags was the first time I went over to my daughter's house. And I started noticing that I couldn't breathe over there. Now, had I been paying attention to my intuition, I would have realized that, oh no, mm-mm. If she get rid of this rabbit, look, Shay, you're gonna have to put your pride aside. You're gonna just suck it up and you ain't getting Peter. You ain't getting Peter today. Peter gonna have to be sold on Craigslist or something. Because you can't have him. Had I paid attention the first time, now then grown an attachment to something you can't get rid of. You're trying to make excuses for it. You're trying to put it outside. You're trying to I'm going to buy him a crate and put a towel over it. But his remnant is already floating in the air. His fur is already floating in the air. So it's already there. You can't get rid of it unless you get rid of the whole thing. Who hear me today? Stop playing. Who hears me for real? What my friend used to say a long time ago. Dawn, shout out to you. She used to say, eat the meat and spit out the bones. If none of this resonates with you, then that's fine. But eat the meat. Pick out, sir. I know you can relate to the relationship thing because I know y'all be walking down the mall sometimes. You be like, what the devil was she? What the world was? I don't know. What the world? Something I said done resonated with you. Stop playing. Okay? Stop it. I already know that I'm about to be blessed and highly favored. I'm already am. But because I don't need no rabbit's foot. And I daggone sure don't need no daggone fertility. Stop playing. But I already know that I'm walking into my abundance. I ain't tripping. Because Peter, look, anybody need a rabbit? His name Pepper. I got to take a picture of him. But he cute as all get out. He is. But I just had to say that because I was like, that just hit me like a ton of bricks. It really did. I'm about to get out this car. I'm so hot. I can't do it. I really can't. I'm about to sit on the porch. Where my keys at? But for real, like, I'm so serious, y'all. I'm so serious. Y'all better pay attention to these little stories and stuff that I be trying to tell y'all. Like, oh, look, here comes Shay talking again. Yes, that's me. I always got a story for you. I always got a little revelation for you. It's just up to you to listen. It's up to you to take what I'm saying at face value. And don't just be like, oh. Shoot.
Oh, there she goes talking again.
Well, I am scared to go in there. Lord, have mercy. I'm going to sit on the porch now. Whew. Throat be caving in and stuff. Sitting on the daggone porch. And then sitting in that daggone truck. Letting the gas run. Like I got money to waste with the daggone AC on. $150-something. I fill that joke up. Yeah, all right. But this is not the time to play, y'all. Some of y'all have some decisions to be made. Some of y'all have some really some y'all really have some decisions to be made. And sometimes it takes a waking up, doing all that for nothing with that little baby on the back of his seat. Man, the summertime bring out some fools. I'm trying to tell you. people just be so ignorant. But anyway, I just had to say that because I was like, the kids gone for the weekend, but my oldest, you know, Lily, she's still here. And they gonna come back to a daggone rabbit that ain't here no more. And I'm gonna have to just tell them, look, Peter went on a journey. Y'all, I'm like, look, y'all remember that movie Easter Egg? Yeah, he took an early Easter egg hunt journey. For real. Even though we don't do Easter and all that, but I'm saying, like, he went to go prepare early. Because mommy was getting sick of him. Literally. But y'all already know what it is. It's your girl Shay Shay from Simply Magnolias and Honey. Just a southern girl living life like it's golden. No matter how thick and sticky life gets, remember it is still what? Golden. Alright, y'all. Bye.